at that, the weather is looking rather nice today. We have a little bit of cloud, but I am pleased to say that it is not raining at all. Yes, we are outside in the garden today. Can you believe it? The weather is that good. It really is. Even though I've just realized it's quite cold, so I might have to go into the house to fetch my coat during today's live stream. Yes, here we go again. We are back once more, live across the world, live in your house. It's English Addict, coming to you live from the birthplace of English, which just happens to be England. Yeah, we are back together once again. Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Are you feeling happy today? I hope you are. We are all here back together again. Yes, it is the weekend. We have made it through not only another week, but also another weekend, because today it is Sunday. Beep, 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 beep. So we are outside today. I've decided to do it outside. As it were. So I'm outside. I hope you are having a good weekend. How was your weekend? Was it a nice weekend, or was it a horrible weekend? I don't know, you see, because I'm not there. That is why I am asking the question, you see. Here we go, English Addict. And yes, I know what you're thinking. Who are you? Who are you? You weird looking man. My name is Mr. Duncan. I talk about the English language. I teach English. I like to chat about the English language because I am an English addict. I love the English language. I like using English. I like talking about English. I like listening to English. And of course, I like teaching English very much as well. Nice to see you here today. A lot of information, a lot of things to tell you today, a lot of things going on, not only today but also during September. Yes, September is just around the corner. As we prepare to say goodbye to August, September will arrive, and with it there will be some changes as well, some big changes concerning this live stream. So during September there will be no English Addict live streams. We are taking a rest from English Addict. However, there is some good news, because there will be new lessons. Mr. Duncan, we can't believe it. Are you kidding? Are you having us on? Are you joking? No, I'm not joking. There will be some new English lessons, coming your way during the month of September. And as a way of kicking off the month, on Tuesday, which just happens to be the 1st of September, I will be once more uploading my autumn lesson. And if you are wondering why I'm doing that, well, there are a couple of reasons. First of all, next week sees the beginning of autumn. Autumn will arrive here in England, and I thought it would be a good idea to upload once more my autumn lesson. For those who know about the problems I had with my autumn lesson, I'm not going to go into details, but let's just say I had quite a few problems concerning copyright. So I've decided to re-edit, remaster in glorious high definition cinema widescreen aspect So from Tuesday, once more, my autumn lesson will be on my YouTube channel. And you can see it from Tuesday. And just to give you a taster, just to give you a hint, there is a photograph taken from my autumn lesson. So it will be available from Tuesday. Tuesday, the 1st of September, is when you can watch my autumn lesson all over again. It will be looking very nice as well. I've spent a lot of time over the past few days re-editing and also remastering, so the picture, the image will be lovely and clear, and everything should look rather nice. So that is the big news. The big news is no more English Addict during September. However, it is not all bad news. There is some good news as well. I will be back with my English Addict live streams in October. So it's only going to be during September, recorded lessons, and then I'm back with you with English Addict in October. Because of course it is a special month. I always celebrate my anniversary of the creation of my YouTube channel. It all started on October the 31st, 2006, which means I've been doing this on YouTube for nearly 14 years. Can you believe it? I can't believe it, to be honest. So that's the big news. Other big news concerning the local area, I suppose, is the harvest has begun. Now, normally the harvest season starts during early August, sometimes late July as well. However, this month it's all happening a little bit later than usual, but the harvest season has started around the area in which I live. And look at that, you can see already around the area some of the harvesting has started. You can see there are lots of bales of hay, and you can see that some of the fields have already been reaped. You reap your crop, you gather your crop. Very nice, Mr. Duncan. So it's all looking rather nice at the moment. You can really tell that autumn is on the way. So when we have the harvest, it normally means that the weather is changing, and also it means that autumn is definitely on the way as the harvest season begins. Oh, isn't that lovely? Some lovely autumnal scenes and, of course, some views of the harvest, which is taking place right now around the area in which I live. Yes, we are live across YouTube on a Sunday. It is the 30th of August as we come towards the end of August. September is just around the corner. And already here in England, it's starting to feel cold. The cold weather has already arrived. It does feel quite chilly today. And as you can see, I've just been into the house and look. I'm wearing my coat. It is still August, but already we are having to put our coats on. It's very chilly at the moment here in England, I must be honest with you. Something we did yesterday that we can't believe we did, but we did. We definitely did it. We put the heating on in the house. We actually became so cold last night, we had to put our heating on in the house. Can you believe it? We actually did it. We put the heating. We never put the heating on in the house during August. Now, we have a public holiday this weekend. It means that everyone will be enjoying their bank holiday Monday. So this Monday, it is a public holiday here in England, and many people will be having the day off, including myself and also Mr. Steve as well. I'm not sure what we're doing on Monday because we have the builders coming as well. A very strange situation indeed. So that's what's happening. And I suppose for many people, it is a lovely long weekend. However, last year here in England, on Bank Holiday Monday at the end of August last year, it was the hottest day in August ever last year. This year, they are saying that we are going to have the coldest day ever in August. So on Monday, apparently the temperature is going to drop quite a lot. And it will still be August, you see, the last day of August tomorrow. But the temperature will not be as high as last year. We had lovely high temperatures last year. In fact, they were so high, it was the highest ever in August. But not this year, unfortunately. In fact, there will be a record broken on Monday. It will be the lowest temperature ever recorded in August. Isn't that amazing? We have lots of people on the live chat. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten you. Mr. Duncan, you're not talking to the live chat. Well, I am now. Hello, live chat. Nice to see you here. It is very good to see you all here today. And can I say a big congratulations to Mary? Hello, Mary. Mary Gow. You are first on today's live chat. Congratulations to you. Very nice, very nice indeed. Congratulations to you, Mary. And also we have, who else is on the live chat today? Let's have a look, shall we? Let us see. Oh, okay then. I don't know what's happened to the live chat, but it's removed everyone from the start. I don't know why it does that. YouTube, I wish you would stop changing things. Oh, by the way, can I just check, do we have live captions today? Do we have live captions? Let me just check. We do. Oh, congratulations, YouTube. Thank you very much for letting me have my live captions. Yes, if you want to have live captions, you can. Can you believe it? Look, press C on your keyboard and you will have live captions. Don't enter it on the live chat, but all you have to do is press C on your keyboard and you will have live captions. Very nice to see so many people here today. Hello to the moderators. Hello, Mika. Hello, Pedro. Pedro Belmont. Palmyra is here. Also, we have Mika, Vitas, and Belarusia. They are your moderators for today. They will make sure that your flight is as comfortable as possible as we go through today's live stream. And can I say a big thank you to my moderators? Because I don't do it very often. Now, my moderators are there to make sure that everything goes well and there isn't too much abuse taking place. Unless, of course, it's me giving the abuse. You see, I'm the only person here that can give abuse. The only person that can. So please, no swearing unless it's absolutely necessary. If you feel that it's necessary, then maybe you can. But please, no swearing, because we do have people of all ages, including adults. And as we all know, adults can become very outraged by things. They really can. Barong is here. Gia. Hello, Gia, as well. Gia Roy. Nice to see you as well. Where are you watching at the moment? Welcome to my little garden here in England. Nice to see you here today. We also have Maria. I'm saying hello to Maria in the garden. Nice to see you here as well. Yes, we have Mr. Steve coming later on. Mr. Steve will be with us in around about 15 minutes from now. I can tell you what Steve is doing at the moment. Steve is in the dining room enjoying his lunch. And to be honest with you, I am feeling a little bit jealous because I have not had any lunch. In fact, I haven't had any breakfast today. I haven't eaten anything, in fact. I haven't had anything to eat. So I'm feeling a little bit hungry at the moment. Hello also to Mirella. Hello, Mirella. Nice to see you here as well on the live chat. I love the fact that there are people right now watching all around the world. Whatever they tell you in the news, when we watch the news, they are always saying that human beings are fighting and causing harm to each other. But there are lots of nice people in the world as well. Sometimes we have to take a moment or two to remember that there are nice people in the world as well. Hello also, Marcia. Hello also. Oh, we have Alessandra. Did I say hello to Luis? Luis Mendez, hello to you as well. We will be playing the sentence game today, doing something slightly different. We will be looking for words beginning with D and, try again, S. Or should I say D and S. So today, in the sentence game, we are looking for words beginning with D and S. Of course, Duncan and Steve, you see? That's why. That's the reason why. So the sentence game coming up later on, a lot of people say, Mr. Duncan, we love playing the sentence game so much. We can't get enough of it. So that is what we are doing a little bit later on. I hope you will stick around for that. A little bit of sad news. As you may know, Steve and myself, we like to go into town on Saturday and have a lovely lunch, normally something very delicious, some sort of food, maybe a little bit of chicken, maybe a little bit of quiche, maybe potatoes, maybe lots of other things as well. Unfortunately, the place that we normally go to yesterday closed its doors for the last time. Quite sad, really. So Mr. Steve and myself went along to our favourite place here in Much Wenlock. The name of the place is Copper Kettle. So yesterday, for the final time, we went to the Copper Kettle to have our final Saturday meal before it closed. In fact, it closed yesterday for the final time. So that's what we did. We went there yesterday. You might be able to see a picture of Mr. Steve and myself. Here it is. So there we are having our last meal at the Copper Kettle. And if you look towards the right of Mr. Steve, you will actually be able to see the Copper Kettle. There is actually a Copper Kettle just next to Mr. Steve's head. So there we are sitting at our favourite table. Table number 10 is no more, because the cafe has closed down. So here I am having my meal. As you can see, I'm enjoying my meal. Also, I am spilling my gravy all over the place. I'm having, what am I having there? I'm having my cottage pie. Cottage pie. So cottage pie is normally made with beef, minced beef. And what did Mr. Steve have? I'm not sure what Steve had, actually. Steve, oh yes, I remember. Steve had roast pork with potatoes, carrots, and cabbage. And as I mentioned, I also had cottage pie with carrots and cabbage and lots of gravy as well. One of the things I will miss about the Copper Kettle is the delicious gravy that they always put on their food. Oh, it's making me feel hungry, to be honest, right now. I'm feeling hungry already. I've only just started my live stream today and already I am feeling hungry. Yes, it does look like a very tasty meal. You are right. So a little bit of sad news there as we went along to our favourite place for the final time before it closes its doors forever. So the building has been sold, and at the moment we don't even know if it's going to be a cafe or restaurant. Maybe it will reopen, perhaps. Who knows? But at the moment it looks as if it's not going to reopen as a cafe or a tea room. So that's not very nice. I must admit I feel a little bit disappointed by that. But that's life. That's life. Nothing lasts forever. That's what we say. Nothing lasts forever. By the way, I suppose I should mention again, this is the final English Addict for a while. We are taking a little break from our live streams. During September, there will be some recorded lessons. I am making some new lessons. I know, it seems unbelievable, but I am going to make some new lessons during September. Oh, I'm just looking at the live chat. I don't want to ignore you. Yes, the reason why the cafe or restaurant, some people call it a restaurant, some people call it a tea room, but it is a place where you can have hot meals and also light refreshments such as cakes and also maybe a cup of tea as well, something nice, you see. But sadly it has closed because the owners are actually retiring, you see. So they've sold the business and the building and they are going to retire from doing it. So that's the reason why it's happening, for those who are wondering. That is why it is happening. We have a birthday. Oh, whose birthday is it today? Can you tell me? Is it, let's see, it is someone's birthday today, but I can't find it. Oh, we have India here today. Hello, India. Nice to see you here as well. We have Dana Jay Pathak watching in India. Nice to see you as well. Mr. Steve will be with us in a few moments, but I thought it would be a nice opportunity to have a look at one of my recorded lessons, because that is what I do, you see. I teach English, I talk about English, and sometimes I'm live, and sometimes I'm recorded. Like this, for example. This is one of my full English lessons, and it is an excerpt from lesson number 26. And then after this, we will have Mr. Steve right here with us.
Oh, there you are. Welcome to another full English lesson coming to you from the birthplace of Winnie the Pooh, Professor Snape, Judy Dench, Hugh Laurie, and of course, the English language, which is why we are all here together now. So without any more dawdling or time wasting, let's get on with today's full English lesson right now. Have you ever been stuck for words? Have you ever been in a situation where you could not think what to say? There are many ways of describing this occurrence. We can say that you are tongue-tied. You have been left speechless. You are stuck for words. You cannot find the words to express yourself. Your mind has gone blank. There are many reasons why you might find yourself unable to speak. Perhaps you are in a state of shock or surprise. An unexpected event can leave you speechless. The surprise can be a nice thing, or it can be something not so nice, such as bad news. If you are giving a speech to a group of people, you might find that your brain suddenly stops working. You become nervous and cannot remember what to say. I'm ever so sorry, my mind has gone blank. After a sudden surprise, you might only be able to say, I'm speechless. You have become tongue-tied and stuck for words. If you try to remember the thing you wanted to mention, you might say, it's on the tip of my tongue. A continuing debate in English usage is the question of when to use who and when to use whom. According to formal grammar, who forms the subjective case and so should be used in subject position in a sentence, as in who decided this. The form whom, on the other hand, forms the objective case and so should be used in object position in a sentence, as in whom do you think we should support? To whom do you wish to speak? Although there are some speakers who still use who and whom according to the rules of formal grammar as stated here, there are many more who rarely use whom at all. Its use has retreated steadily and is now largely restricted to formal contexts. The normal practice in modern English is to use who instead of whom, and where applicable, to put the preposition at the end of the sentence. Who do you wish to speak to? Who do you think we should support? Such uses today are broadly accepted in standard English.
Dip, 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 do, do. I hope you enjoyed that. One of my full English lessons. That was an excerpt from Full English number 26. We will have a look at another one of my Full English lessons a little bit later on. Yes, this is English Addict. We are live on Sunday. The pigeons are very excited today because it is their last chance to find a girlfriend, you see. So many of the male pigeons at the moment, they're rushing around trying to find a girlfriend to mate with before the weather starts to change. And here he is, look, talking about mating. Here is my best mate, Mr. Steve.
Hello, hello everybody. Yes, Mr. Duncan, the last time for a month.
Yes, we are taking a little break from English Addict, but it's not bad news. Don't worry, we're not going away forever. Although I have a feeling, Steve, some people might be getting excited, you see. They might be thinking,
surely not.
Thank goodness for that. We've got rid of them. But no, we are taking a break with English Addict just during September. But in October, we will be back with you with English Addict number 117. So don't worry about that, but there will be lots of things to look forward to and hopefully enjoy during September, including my autumn lesson, which will be returning to my YouTube channel. And I've been very busy in the studio re-editing and making it look lovely and fresh and new. And it will be released on my YouTube channel on Tuesday, the 1st of September. In fact, there will be new videos every Tuesday during September. Isn't that nice?
Well, you're going to be very busy, aren't you, Mr. Duncan?
Yes, I'm going to be very
busy. You're
going
to be very busy, just as I have been very busy. By the way, it's Rosa's birthday today.
Rosa Celia.
Yes, I've noticed that on the live chat. So happy birthday to Rosa. Lots of people have been saying happy birthday to you, but I wish to add mine as well.
Happy birthday, Rosa Celia. I hope you have a super duper day where you are, and I hope you get lots of presents and lots of lovely cake. Ooh. We were talking about something just now, Steve. I was discussing with my lovely live chat the sadness that we felt yesterday.
Oh, yes, the last time we were able to eat at our favourite little cafe stroke restaurant called the Copper Kettle. Yes, because the owners have sold this establishment.
Yeah.
And we don't know whether the new owners are going to open it as a restaurant or not.
It's looking unlikely at the moment. It looks like it might not be actually opening again or reopening as a cafe, or tea room. There are many ways of describing this sort of place. Some people say tea room, some people say cafe, but this particular place serves all sorts of food. At least it used to, but sadly now it doesn't, because yesterday it closed for the last time.
For the last time, and we were there having the last home-cooked food, the lovely pies that they produce. There we are. Blimey, I look horrible there. Oh, you haven't put it up yet, Mr. Duncan.
Steve sometimes confuses the preview screen with the output screen.
That's our favourite seat.
There it is, table 10. But table 10 is no more. It is now just a distant memory.
Well, we were going to take it with us. We were going to distract them and walk out with that table.
I was hoping she would. Well, you know what I wanted, Steve? I wanted the little number 10 to take with us, because normally the tables have numbers on them, but they wouldn't let us. And you can see next to Mr. Steve's head, that's what I like, you can actually see a copper kettle.
Yes.
I like that.
Yes, they actually, lots of people have been congratulating me, by the way, on my rendition of I Am What I Am rendition. So thank you very much. Thank you very much for your lovely comments.
Mr. Steve's head has been swelling up
Not at all.
Because of his ego.
I don't have a big ego, Mr. Duncan. You should know that by now. Will you leave my zips alone? No, well, I entered it for a competition at work. More news on that another day.
Yes.
And so Mr. Duncan decided to put it onto the internet because we've got a competition at work for anybody who is a performer and would like to do something like that. So I decided to do that. Mr. Duncan recorded it and we sent it off. So thank you very much for your lovely comments. There may be more.
Mm.
Mightn't there? Because Mr. Duncan's very keen on filming me doing performances for various songs, so I think we may be doing some more of that, and maybe a little concert.
We had some
could be in the offing.
Yes, in the offing.
Yes, yeah. In the offing.
No one says that, by the way, anymore.
They do.
No one says in the offing.
It just means that that might be available. If you say something's in the offing,
we have intruders
be
by
available.
Yes, all right, Steve.
We get it.
Intruders? Where?
Intruder. Did you see the intruders? We had intruders going by, yes, just now.
We'll have to set the cows on them.
Yes, that might be the reason why. They were walking right by the back of our house. Don't they realise that is private property?
Somebody, Sergio says, who is that man? He's like a flame. Really? Or was he dressed in red?
I don't know.
But we'll have to watch it later, won't we?
I have no idea.
Yes. We're wearing jackets, yes we are, because it's very cold today, unseasonally cold.
It's freezing.
In fact, they've said it's the coldest bank holiday weekend. This is a bank holiday weekend that we're having at the moment in the UK, towards the end of public holiday. And it's the coldest, I think, on record.
So when we have a public holiday, we normally call it a bank holiday. So that's the term we use here in England. We say we are having a bank holiday. So on Monday, it is bank holiday. Normally, it happens at the end of August. And one of the strange things is last year, it was the hottest August day ever.
Yes.
And this year, it's going to be the coldest. Can you believe it? So that's the reason why we are standing in the garden. Now, we really should be in our T-shirts. But the temperature is so low today, we actually have to put our coats on.
It's only about 17, 18 degrees centigrade. Yes, whereas last year it was 36, was it, last year?
No, not that high, fortunately. 33.
33, that's still high.
36, that would be amazing.
So it's almost half the temperature it was last year. So global warming, it's not here today.
It's not global warming.
We've got northerly winds, hence we're wearing jackets to keep ourselves warm.
I think it's global cooling. It's the opposite.
Lots of people asking after me. It's very kind of you.
That's very kind of you.
It's very kind because we won't be here for... Well, I don't know, because you know Mr. Duncan, he might do a surprise lesson.
Well, I won't be doing any live streams during September. I've already said that. No live streams during September. I'm going to be working very hard making new content. So that is filming. Well, first of all, I have to write the scripts. I film them, I edit them, I put them together, and then I upload them. So that's what I'm doing during September. No live streams during September. It's all recorded. But don't worry, because I will be back in October and we will have English Addict again, you see. It's only during September. There are many reasons why I'm doing that, but most of them I'm not going to go into at the moment. But there are some reasons.
But you're making some other lessons, aren't you, Mr. Duncan?
Well, new lessons.
New lessons, and so you have to have time to do that. It takes you a long time to film, edit, compose the lessons, get them all ready, getting them to look good, and having suitable content for your lovely viewers to learn English.
I'm also hoping that I will be able to see my mother during September. And this is one of the changes that is taking place here in England as we come to the end, or as we start to ease the lockdown here in England. So I'm hoping finally, after many months of not seeing my mother, who is in care, I should be able to go and see her. We are hoping next weekend, maybe. So we are keeping our fingers crossed, perhaps, maybe. So that's another thing I want to do in September, is going to see my mum. because she's been very ill for some time now, and I've not been able to see her because of lockdown.
How annoying. Urgh. But yes, it'll be very nice for you to go and see your mother.
It will. So I'm looking forward to doing that as well. We have the sentence game coming up a little bit later on. We are looking at words beginning with D and S, you see, because of Duncan and Steve, you see.
I see. Well, DS.
Yes.
There was a car, a Citroën, called a Citroën DS.
Okay.
So anybody in France... or anybody who has a lot of Citroëns in their country, will concur with me on that.
Okay.
And maybe Lewis can say that he's seen a Citroën DS. I think it was a car from the sort of 70s or 80s. I seem to remember quite a stylish car, as Citroëns always have been. But yes, DS always reminds me of a Citroën.
Is that the car that floats on air?
I think it is. I think it is. I think it was a particularly stylish car.
Yes.
From France. So will somebody, Lewis, maybe somebody watching in France, just confirm that I'm right about that? I think I am.
Well, I think my Uncle Stan had a Citroën DS, and it used to float around on air. It was amazing. When he started the car, it would rise up on a cushion of air. It was quite amazing. It was like something from science fiction.
Now, Marie, a couple of people have asked, have they finished the work on the house? Not quite.
No, they're coming on Monday.
Tomorrow.
It's supposed to be a public holiday tomorrow. And we have the builders coming, so I'm a little annoyed about that. I'm not going to pretend not to be slightly annoyed that they're coming tomorrow, because it's supposed to be a public holiday, and I was hoping to get a little rest from all of the banging. There's been a lot of banging taking place.
There has. They've had a few hold-ups this week, so they've got to come back for a morning tomorrow. Actually... there's an interesting subject to do with, if you have people working on your house, should you give them a tip if you're not directly paying them, because they work for a company?
Well, you are paying them.
And I'm not paying the workmen directly.
No,
they're being paid by the companies who are installing the windows for us.
Yes.
But we've got people coming to work here at the house, and I'm debating whether I should give them a tip.
Tip.
A little small sum of money to say thank you very much.
We normally call it a gratuity.
Gratuity or a tip.
So a good example of a tip, I suppose, is in a restaurant. So you have a meal, you enjoy the meal, don't you? You go, that was a really nice meal. Ooh, lovely. And then when you pay the bill, you leave a little bit of extra money as a tip.
Tip for the waiter or waitress, because... you don't. When you pay for that meal, you're paying the restaurant, and of course the waiters or the waitresses don't get paid very much generally, particularly in America, where they rely very heavily on tips to supplement their wages. So this is a similar situation. We're having workmen here, but we're not paying them to do the work. We're paying the company they work for.
Yes, but they will be paid. But they are getting paid.
Oh, well, yes, that's what I'm saying. It's the same as a restaurant. Yeah. So the restaurant employs a waiter or waitress. They get paid, but a low wage. Then you pay the restaurant for the food, and then you give a tip to the waiter. So this is similar. The company that the builders are... employed by,
yes.
I'm paying the company, not the builders directly, so I feel as though I should give them a little extra, a little tip
to
say thank you.
Basically, they're being subcontracted. So the windows are being put in by the company, but the builders who are doing all of the work are actually being paid by the company. So it's kind of subcontracted. But Steve wants to give them a tip.
Yes. The DS was a car used by the French heads of state. Yes.
Oh.
It was a big car, and you always saw the presidents and the prime ministers coming out of these cars in France.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Yes. It was, I was going to say that, actually. curry. But yes, you are right. I seem to remember that. So in the UK, you always see sort of heads of state and head politicians coming out of Jaguars. In France, in Germany, it's always BMWs or Mercedes, usually. Obviously, in France, it's the top end Citroen.
So does that mean you're German?
No, I'm not a head of state.
No. Sometimes you are in a state, in a terrible state.
Ah, Corey, yes, the Citroen DS Palace 2.3.
Oh.
The car of Fan Thomas. I don't know who that is. Sergio says you can always let the waiter eat up your lunch. What, you mean the leftovers?
I'm not sure if that's a good... That's a good thing to do. Anyway, Steve wants to give a tip to the builders who are doing some work on the house. And Steve wanted... I'm looking forward to getting my tips, by the way. If anyone wants to give me a tip today, you are more than welcome to do so. Shall I give the address quickly? Here's the address. I don't know why my little mouse on my computer isn't working very well today. It's being very annoying. It keeps stopping.
Perhaps it needs a new battery.
It might need a new battery. That's going to be very embarrassing if it fails. So if you want to give me a tip, talking of which, you can also give me a tip on the live chat and here as well. If you want to give me a little tip, you are more than welcome to do so.
Of course, and another meaning of the word tip is to give somebody some advice, a little piece of advice.
Yes.
So if you say, I'm going to give you a tip, you could say, well, I think you should shave that beard off. It doesn't look very nice. Little tip, you look a lot nicer if you shave that beard off. So if you give someone a little piece of advice, you're also giving them a tip. I suppose in a way you're giving them something, just like you would give them money if it was a tip in a restaurant.
Yes.
Jayendra has said, instead of a tip, what about serving food and drinks? Well, I have been making them lots of hot drinks, coffee. But we've got two workers here. Only one of them is drinking coffee.
What's the other one drinking? Whiskey?
Well, I don't know. I haven't seen him drink, but he doesn't like tea and coffee. So I've been making, in fact, yesterday, on Friday,
okay,
I made four drinks.
Four?
Four cups of coffee.
What, at the same time? What, he had four cups of coffee, one after the other?
He likes his coffee.
I've noticed.
Just one.
I've noticed.
And he likes milk and two sugars in it as well. Carl is his name.
Carl, okay. To be honest with you, I've decided to be the mysterious person in the background. So I'm having nothing to do with the workmen or the building work or anything. I'm staying out of the way because I always feel more comfortable doing that, you see. I like to be the mysterious person in the shadows. And Mr. Steve is doing all the front work, you see, dealing with them directly, making their cups of coffee, and of course giving them their tips as well.
Well, Mohammed Hussein Hassim Obi says, my tip is to read a lot of different books. There we go. There's a different use of the word tip.
Yes.
Giving some advice, a little piece of advice. Read lots of books, because that will broaden your mind, broaden your experience, and your understanding of different things.
You know, in some places, it's rude to leave a tip. Did you know that?
Mika says in Japan, they don't leave tips for anything.
No, I think Japan is one of the places I was going to mention. So in Japan, you don't leave tips. I like that. I might go to Japan, actually. I can live and never have to tip anyone. I like that. You have the right idea there.
Well, if you go to America...
America.
You're going to have to tip for everything.
You mean,
I think I'm right in saying that certainly in restaurants, it's you have to be a big tipper.
The most embarrassing one, I think the embarrassing one is when you go to a hotel, and I'm never sure when you give a tip. So maybe someone will help you to your room with your bags, or maybe they will show you to the room. And then afterwards, there is always that strange, uncomfortable silence. And you're not sure, do I have to give you a tip for doing that or not? It depends. I think it depends on the class of hotel. I think if it's a one-star hotel, I don't think you have to. But if you're staying in a five-star hotel, I think you do. I think you definitely have to give tips for everything. Even if someone says good morning to you, I think you have to give them at least £10.
You're joking. Bella has used another usage of the word tip. I saw the tip of a mountain.
Oh, I see, yes.
Yes.
The tip.
The top piece.
Yes. The tip is the very end.
So the tip, that is the tip of your finger, tip. Mr. Duncan.
The tip, you see. Beep.
Yes. Three uses of the word tip.
That looks so rude. Does that look rude to you?
Well, you always see rude things in everything, Mr. Duncan.
Sorry about that.
It's
that,
just a finger.
I've just realised that looks quite obscene.
It doesn't. Only if you've got a twisted, perverted mind, Mr. Duncan.
Well, that's
anyone
true.
Else would think that's just a finger.
That's true. It is. It is. I do have a twisted and perverted mind. You're right.
Well, not only is it... I've got something else. Not only is it Rose's birthday today, it's Partap's birthday as well.
No, it isn't.
Oh, isn't it?
No. Partap keeps saying they have a birthday every time we're on.
Really?
How many birthdays have you had?
Well, right, I have to remember this.
Yes.
Really?
Yeah, the same thing happened last week.
Are you having us on, Partap?
Yes. No, it's not Partap's birthday.
Crying wolf. So one day it will be your birthday and you'll say it's your birthday and we won't believe you.
Yes, that's it, you see. The boy that cried wolf, you see. There is the story, the famous story of the boy who ran into the village shouting, wolf, wolf, wolf. And all the villagers ran for cover. But the boy was only joking. He was only making a joke. The problem is, the next time he called it, he really meant there was a wolf there. There was really a wolf. And no one believed it. Yes. And the wolves came and they ate everyone in the village. They gobbled them all down. Don't cry wolf. Like the boy that cried wolf.
Mm-hmm. And the wolf came and ate him. Yes. Lots of people are making comments about the Citroën DS. Lewis says it is a beautiful and attractive car. I agree with you. Very stylish, as you'd expect from anything from France.
Anyone from Citroën watching? Can you send us? I don't know. Maybe a wheel hub, or a steering wheel.
But some people are also making interesting comments that the quality wasn't very good. That's often a criticism levelled at French cars, I've got to say.
Mind you,
Mr. Duncan. Uh-huh. I was reading, as you know, I like cars. I was wanted to read a road test of a Maserati Quattroporte.
Okay.
Which is a four-door car by Maserati, which is, you know, up there with Ferrari, really.
Yeah, Maserati.
Maserati, and it gets shocking write-ups. It's a beautiful looking car.
Okay.
But I didn't read a single good write-up of it. Sorry if anybody from Italy is watching, but I think I'll stick to Ferraris if I ever get rich, because they said that this Maserati, I read about five or six reviews of it, and people said it was shockingly unreliable. cost them a fortune.
So how much would this car cost?
About £100,000.
For a car?
It's probably the most, well, I would say easily the most stylish and exclusive four-door saloon car you can buy.
How crazy is that?
Maserati Quattroporte. It's got a V8 engine. It's very incredibly stylish. I mean, it's just drop-dead gorgeous to look at.
Okay.
Unfortunately, quality-wise, according to the write-ups I've read, it is very poor quality, which is a shame.
Yeah, I think so. So when we talk about cars generally, Steve, is there a certain manufacturer that you would avoid yourself personally?
I think these days most cars are very, very reliable. I mean, okay. In the past I would have certainly singled out certain manufacturers, but I won't say it now because I think generally cars are quite reliable. But I mean, in this country, we've got a famous company called Land Rover.
Land Rover.
Land Rover, and they are renowned for being very unreliable cars. Oh,
so
Range Rovers.
So don't buy a Land Rover.
Range Rovers get very, always come last. Yes. Very. Unfortunately, Fiats don't get a good write-up.
Fiats, Italian.
But any sort of, the reliable cars tend to be, I've got to say, really, cars from sort of Japan, really.
Japan?
Hondas, things like that.
Yes.
Nissan, they tend to be the most reliable.
Or
Skoda's very reliable as well.
Yeah.
In fact, in the UK, Skoda tends to come top of customer satisfaction surveys.
It's interesting that you do see a lot of Japanese cars on the road here in the UK. If you look around, you always see Toyotas, Hondas, everywhere. So I think it would be fair to say that Japanese cars and German cars are very popular here in England.
Well, I think German cars are generally reliable, but I think the most reliable tend to be the Japanese cars.
Well, we saw a Tesla yesterday. I've never seen one before in England. And I saw my first Tesla yesterday, someone driving it. It just creeps by silently. It's very weird. It's almost as if the car is rolling down a hill. but it's actually going. It's actually operating. but it's so quiet. It just goes by like a ghost.
Apparently, you've got to be very careful if you've got an electric car and you're driving around car parks in supermarkets, because people tend to step out in front of you because they can't hear you coming.
Yes. So I would imagine over the next few years, as these cars become more popular, you might find more people being hit by the cars, especially in supermarket car parks. So a lot of people will be knocked over or hit by these cars because they are so quiet. Anyway, we seem to be talking about cars.
Can I just say one thing? Yes, Palmyra, I'm still dreaming about a Mustang.
Oh, I wish you'd make your mind up.
Yes. Anyway, let's not go into that.
I wish he keeps changing his mind, though, about which car. He says the Ford Mustang, and then he forgets that, and he says, I can't have that. It's too ostentatious. Can you imagine paying £100,000 for a car? Who would do that? Who buys a car for £100,000?
Rich people. Yes, Saturina, you're right. The engine in a Maserati is the same as a Ferrari.
Oh, okay.
It's a Ferrari. It is, yes. But the engine's fine. It's the rest of the car, apparently, that's not very good. The gearbox. Anyway, let's not go into that. Mr. Duncan wants to change subject.
But you're quite fussy, aren't you?
I could talk about cars all day.
Yes, I think you are.
I read a lot about them.
It almost feels as if you're talking about cars all day right now.
I don't work in the motor trade. Somebody asked, I don't. But I wish I had done. I missed my vocation in life, was to work for a car manufacturer.
Okay.
Or in sales or something to do with cars.
Well, you still could.
True.
You could work in a factory, putting the wheels onto Mercedes-Benzes.
In Russia, said Sergio, they've got a saying, if a Range Rover is moving, it's going to a mechanic. That's very true. I mean, you can't believe that people buy Range Rovers. They're about £80,000-£90,000, and yet they're always going wrong, unfortunately. They're not very reliable.
These are very high amounts of money. I can't believe how much money people spend on cars. Because as you can tell, I don't own a car. I'm not a car driver. Mr. Steve likes cars, but I don't drive at all. At all. We have the sentence game coming a little bit later on, by the way, for those who are wondering what the hell this is.
Lewis has mentioned a television programme starring Tony Curtis.
Ah, the Persuaders?
Yes. Which, unless you're of a certain age...
Okay.
Over a certain age, I would say over 50...
Okay.
You're not going to know what that programme is.
But these programmes are shown around the world, they even now. They are internationally known. I think there will be lots of people who remember that programme. It only ran for one season because it was a disaster, apparently. Nobody watched it. Can you believe it?
Tony Curtis and also
Roger Moore.
Roger Moore.
Yes, they were both in that programme, but it failed. It was a flop. They cancelled the programme after just one season. Did you know that?
Ali Jabbery wants you to pronounce the word beautiful.
You are so beautiful to me. Yes, you are. You are so beautiful. Can't you see? You're everything I've ever wanted. You're everything I need. You are so beautiful to me.
Well, you didn't ask for a song, but you got one, Ali.
You got one.
Yes. If you're American, it's beautiful. Beautiful. What a beautiful day.
Pedro Belmont asks a very interesting question. Steve, would you have the courage to buy a Chinese car?
Well, I don't think we have any for sale in the UK.
I've never seen. There are quite a few makes of Chinese car that I did actually see when I was in China. So they do exist.
But I don't. Cannot buy, as far as I'm aware, you cannot buy a Chinese car in the UK. We don't have any dealerships for Chinese cars.
Mm.
Japanese, yes, but not Chinese.
Mm.
So maybe one day we will.
Maybe one day. Who knows?
Sergio says, what do you think of Jonathan Pye?
Jonathan Pye is a character who is very funny. Sometimes he swears a lot. And what he actually is, he's not real. He's not a real person. He's an actor playing the part of a news reporter. But in between the reports that he gives, he starts shouting and screaming at the camera about various topics, let's just say. But yes, we are both big fans of Jonathan Pye. We were watching him this morning.
We were watching him this morning, his latest video.
Yes, so he's actually a British actor, and he plays the part of a TV news correspondent. But he's very funny, even though he swears and shouts and he gets very angry about things.
He's a political sort of commentator, and he criticises the government very heavily.
Hmm.
In his, I suppose you would say there were. Would you say it was comedy? It's sort of.
It's actually satire.
Satire. That's
so
right.
So he's actually satirising the way in which news reporting is done. And over the past few weeks, the BBC has been heavily criticised for its coverage of politics and various other subjects as well. So, yes, yes, we both like Jonathan Pye. So we can definitely say that we like him. He's on YouTube and he's very popular.
Pedro's going.
Oh, okay.
Bye, Pedro. See you in a month.
See you in a month, Pedro. We will miss you.
Yes. Yes, the Persuaders got a big success due to the cars and the women.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
There were lots of cars and lots of women. And, of course, I suppose some of the women were watching for the sexy men as well, you see?
Well, one sexy man is going. And with long hair. So we'll see you in a month.
Very nice. Anyway, we are actually doing our final English Addict for August, but also it will be the last one for a few weeks. We will be back in October live, and there will be new lessons during September. So there is lots and lots for you to watch.
I think I'll make a lesson, Mr. Duncan, on how to repoint a wall.
Yes, it's a bit late now. You're finished.
It's true.
You finished the job.
But I've got so many super skills now, Mr. Duncan. I could imagine if I could do a job on the side, repointing people's walls.
Yes, you could go around the local neighbourhood.
I think £200 a day, I think.
You could be an odd job man.
I'll go and knock people's walls down at night.
Okay.
And then go around in the day and say, would you like me to put your wall back together?
Well, you've kind of let the secret out now, haven't you? So if you live nearby to us and your walls start falling down, there's a good chance it's Mr. Steve trying to get some business.
I could start with our neighbour. She had a wall knocked down by a what we think is a red van could well have been the postman.
It was only you mean the wall that was damaged 5 years ago?
Yeah, she hasn't had it repaired.
No.
But then it's in a very vulnerable position. I think she's waiting for somebody to go into it so that it completely collapses and then she can have it repaired.
Are you enjoying this conversation about our neighbour's wall? Is it enjoyable? Now you can see why I'm stopping my live streams.
You all know this. Lewis has said, what is the series with Robert Wagner in?
Ah, that was Heart to Heart.
Heart to Heart.
It was murder. This is Mrs. Hart. She's gorgeous. And when they met, it was murder.
Yes, it was sort of husband and wife detective team, wasn't it?
Robert Wagner was famously married to Natalie Wood. Ooh. Yes. And you remember there was a bit of a scandal because Natalie Wood died after falling into the sea from a boat, and there have been many rumours, many things said about her death, including links to Robert Wagner. It's true. Over the years,
conspiracy theory. Is he still alive, Robert Wagner?
Robert Wagner is still alive. He does pop up in a TV show called NCIS. He often pops up in that. So, yes, he's still around and he's still acting. But over the years, he has been questioned over the death of Natalie Wood after she drowned in mysterious circumstances. Ooh.
So that wasn't the lady he played opposite with in Heart to Heart?
No, that was Stephanie Powers.
Stephanie Powers.
Stephanie Powers.
Yes.
A lot of teenage boys really fancied Stephanie Powers.
The mother figure.
She was a MILF.
Well,
that's what they call them. If there was a lady who may be of a certain age, maybe in her 40s or 50s, but she's very attractive, you will describe her as a MILF. MILF.
Well, that, if she is seducing younger men.
I'm not going to tell you
what you mean, isn't it?
I'm not going to tell you what that means, by the way, because it's very rude.
Yes. Starsky and Hutch was a very popular show, and Hazard, Saturino. Do you mean the Dukes of Hazard?
The Dukes of Hazard, which now, of course, is no longer politically correct, because the
what
car
is
because the car that they drove around in. Can you name the car?
Because
you like cars, you should be able to name the
wasn't
the,
named after. Oh, it wasn't Daisy. It was Daisy. Was the girl
Daisy
with the well endowed girl?
Okay.
The Dukes of Hazzard.
Sorry about that.
All the men used to watch. That's why the only reason my father used to watch the Dukes of Hazzard was for Daisy, and then you had Boss Hogg, didn't you?
Yes.
And a couple of strapping young men, yes, driving around in an iconic American sports car.
They were the Duke boys, they were the Dukes of
Hazzard. I used to like that.
I'm trying to explain something, Steve. Wait there, before you interject again. So, the car, what's it called? Tell me the name.
I don't know.
The General Lee.
Which
was, of course, named after a very controversial character. And on top of the car, there was the Confederate flag, which now, of course, has become something that you can't show anywhere in the United States. It's become something that is kind of banned, and because of that, you don't see the Dukes of Hazzard shown very often on television for that very reason.
And yet it was a very entertaining, funny show.
Yes, I used to like the A-Team.
I was never a fan of the A-Team.
I used to like the A-Team. I loved George Peppard. I don't know why, but George Peppard, he had a certain character. And of course, there was Mad Murdoch as well.
Who was in another.
I thought you were going to insult me then. I was waiting for an insult from Steve. I thought he was going to say, oh, yes, I know, Mad Murdoch, because you're a bit mad, aren't you, Mr. Duncan?
I wasn't going to say that.
That's very nice of you.
Well, look at that. Saturino has mentioned a programme. Don't know how we got onto programmes.
I don't either. I think it's your fault.
a horror series called Prisoners of the Stones.
Prisoners of the Stones. That might actually be Children of the Stones.
Is that the one, the very old sort of 1970s
British children's
horror? Is that the one? But maybe not.
Yes, Prisoners of the Stones. I think it might be that, and it's just been renamed.
Maybe.
Because sometimes when they make a TV show and they show it in other countries, they actually change the name. Change the name.
It is cold here, Mohammed, yes. For, unexpectedly, we've mentioned this earlier, it is August, and it's the coldest period of time ever recorded at this time of the year.
Yeah.
For many, many years.
Outside the Arctic Circle.
Yes, so it's only about 18 degrees out here. It should be at least sort of mid-20s. Yes, there we go.
Partridge Aves says, yes, it's some very sad news. Chadwick Boseman, who appeared in Black Panther, an actor who had appeared in quite a few movies, sadly died. He actually carried on making movies and performing and acting whilst he was being treated for a very serious form of cancer. Very sad news.
Saturino, the car in the Dukes of Hazzard was a Dodge, probably a Dodge Charger, which is a direct rival to the Ford Mustang. And in fact, I think in the famous Steve McQueen Bullet movie with that very famous car chase in San Francisco, it was the baddies were in the Dodge Charger, I think I'm right in this, and of course the good guy Steve McQueen was in the Ford Mustang.
Okay,
so they've always been rival cars, I think, in the States. Tales from the Crypt. All these old programs coming up.
I don't remember that. I think Tales from the Crypt was an American TV show. So I don't actually remember that one. I think that was made in the United States.
We had one called Tales of the Unexpected.
Tales of the Unexpected. They were normally stories with a horrific twist at the end. All of them, I believe they were written by Roald Dahl, well known for his rather dark stories aimed at children.
Valor says, Mr. Duncan, are you going to retire?
I'm not really. Am I going to retire? No, I'm going to carry on doing this until I die, basically, because I don't think I can afford to retire. I can't retire. I can't afford it. I will be working until the last breath leaves my carcass. I think so.
Andy says it's time to play the sentence game. You're right.
In fact, I think I've lost count or lost track of time. What time is it? I can't believe it. It's 22 minutes past three.
40 or 38 minutes before you won't see us for a month. So let's get on, Mr. Duncan.
That was very accurate.
Yes. So, yes, I'm looking forward to the sentence game because it's going to be more difficult today because there are two letters, which I think is going to test people's English skills to the max.
Well, that's the reason why we're doing it, you see. I'm freezing, by the way.
Are you?
I'm so cold, I can't begin to tell you how cold I am.
Shall I snuggle up to you, Mr. Duncan, and keep you warm?
I'd rather not. I think the
rejected again.
The neighbours might start talking. They might say, oh, those two guys, what are they up to in their garden? Talking to themselves.
You could go and run around the garden to warm up. Of course, I've been repointing the wall, so I've been doing manual work, so I'm fit and healthy and warm, glowing from the inside out. I had porridge. I bet you haven't eaten it. Have you eaten anything today, Mr. Duncan?
No, I haven't.
There we go. That's why you're cold, because you haven't eaten anything. He's so busy preparing for the live streams on a Sunday. He doesn't eat. And how long have you been up now, Mr. Duncan? It's 3:30. So you've been up since 12 o'clock, is it? You've been up since about 9 o'clock. So that's 6 hours. You've eaten nothing. So that's why you're cold. And of course, that's the other reason you're taking a month off, is to refuel your body with food. Because you miss out every time you have a live stream. He's so busy preparing that he doesn't eat anything.
Okay. Have you finished?
Yes.
Here we go then. Let's play the sentence game.
Play the sentence game.
And then as soon as we've done this, we can get the hell out of here. And you won't be seeing me for 4 weeks. Oh, bliss.
The thing is, Mr. Duncan, is you'll be so hungry after this, you won't have anything healthy.
I'm hungry
you'll
now.
You'll just stuff your face full of biscuits and sweets.
You've got no room to talk.
What? I've had porridge.
Yes.
I've had porridge this morning, oats with milk and blueberries,
yes.
Plus an orange. Then I had some eggs for lunchtime. So I've been very healthy today. In fact, my energy levels are soaring. I can feel them soaring, Mr. Duncan.
Okay, Steve, I don't think anyone's listening to what you're saying, to be honest.
Why not?
I can see the viewing figures going down as we
stand. Well, they want the sentence game, that's why.
Yes, well...
Don't leave, we're playing it now.
Okay, Steve, well, how about we do it now then? It's time, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for us to play...
It's...
The sentence game. The sentence game, Steve. Are you excited? Ooh, I'm excited.
I'm excited.
I'm excited.
Porridge oats, Mohammed.
For goodness sake. Okay, then. Let's play the sentence game, shall we? Or else we'll be here till midnight. The sentence game, it's very easy. You can play the sentence game at home if you want to. You don't have to. It's not the law. But if you want to play the sentence game, today we are using two letters. Ah, you see, two. S and D. S for Steve and D for Duncan. Of course, S can also be super, dynamic, sensational, delicious, you see. So these words...
Sensitive.
Sensitive, like Mr. Steve. And
delinquent.
Delinquent. That's a great word. A delinquent is a person who is often antisocial. They do things that they shouldn't. They do things that might be even illegal.
Upsetting.
Forbidden. Interesting. I like it. Here we go then. Shall we play the sentence game, Steve?
Yes.
For goodness sake, get on with it. I can hear people now shouting out of their windows. For goodness sake, Mr. Duncan, get on with it. Here we go then. We are using letters D and S. Here is the first sentence game. So the first missing letter, the first missing word begins with
D.
And the second one begins with
S.
There you go. And that... is the sentence.
Well, S something with six letters. How D something with six letters, your punishment will be later.
Yes, we will something, how something, your punishment will be later. We will something, how something, your punishment will be later. It seems like every single dog in the village is barking today. I don't know why. Is it you, Steve? I think maybe you are upsetting the dogs.
I was howling earlier, so that's probably what it was.
Can you smell burning?
I think someone's having a barbecue.
Someone's having a barbecue. That's not fair.
Well, I hope it's a barbecue and not, you know, not our house on fire.
Okay. Now that does smell like a barbecue.
It smells like a barbecue.
Someone's having a barbecue and they haven't invited us.
They don't like us around here.
Can you see? Can you see what happens around here? We are pariahs. Pariahs of the neighbourhood. We are outcasts. People having barbecues and they don't even invite us to have a nibble on a sausage.
Well, we've got answers coming through already.
Oh, yes. I almost forgot there. We're playing the sentence game, aren't we?
Well, yes. Yes, we've got several correct, correct answers and alternatives to what Mr. Duncan is probably going to propose.
Okay.
As the suggested answers. Well done. I think we're there, Mr. Duncan. I think
we've
got the, yes.
go to the latest comments. That's it. That's it. Just click the blue thing there, and we can go to the latest comments. Oh, I see. Yes. Oh, amazing. So last week, you see, when I had the sentence game last week, I was accused of making it too difficult. So I imagine today I'm going to be accused of making it too easy. I can't win, you see. I just can't win. Here we go. Where's Mr. Cockerel? I've missed my Cockerel. He's sitting behind Mr. Steve. Come on, Mr. Cockerel. Can you please announce the answer? I wonder if the neighbours think that that's a real cockerel. Is that a real cockerel? Did someone hear the cockerel? Here it is then, Steve. Here comes the answer.
And Mora... Yes, go on.
No?
I think Mora was the first to get both words correct.
Oh, Mora.
Yes, if that's... Assuming that's what you're going to come up with.
Mora Mattacini. I love your name, by the way. I love that. The answer is, or should I say, the answers are... Bing!
Decide and severe. There we go. Mora was first.
Decide, severe. So let me explain. We will decide how severe your punishment will be later. So you decide, you come to a decision. We will come to a decision. We will decide how severe... I suppose another word you could use is harsh. Harsh. Something that is severe. It is harsh. Maybe something that is brutal or perhaps even unfair as well.
Well,
severe.
Preeti has also suggested that you could use the word strict.
Hmm.
Yes, you could use the word strict in there.
Yes, because it's the same number of letters.
Preeti was the first to get the first word right, which was decide.
Mm.
But the word should, we will, yes, yep. So should doesn't quite fit there.
No.
It's six letters, but it doesn't fit grammatically.
No, grammatically it doesn't work, but we will decide how strict. That's a good one. Yes, you can have severe punishment or you can have strict punishment.
Serious is a seven letter word, unfortunately.
Are you sure that's a barbecue and not the house on fire?
Do you want me to go or strong, says Fedor?
This is very good.
You could have the word strong in there. Mm. Yes, definitely.
We will something how something your punishment will be. Decide severe are the answers that I had. And that is it. Well done to those who got it right.
Not sure that is a barbecue. It smells more like burning...
It is a barbecue, definitely. That's charcoal.
Okay.
It smells like charcoal to me, Steve. Charcoal and maybe paraffin. Or something that you use to light your barbecue. Someone's having a barbecue and they haven't invited us.
They don't like us around here, but then we don't like them either.
They don't like us. We're too strange, you see. They say, oh, there they are. Those two strange people walking down the road. Oh, they're so strange.
They stand in front of cameras in their garden and talk to people.
They talk to themselves in the garden. They have a camera. Ooh, what are they up to? What are they doing? Ooh, that sort of thing. Here we go then. Here is the next
one.
Sentence game coming up right now. We are looking for D and S. You see like that? Oh, well done, Steve. Steve was using his initiative there, you see. D and S. A little bit higher. There you go. Yes. So the first... missing word begins with D,
yes.
And the second one begins with S, you see? I want to something my award to those who've something over the years. Ah.
Is this anything to do with you, Mr. Duncan?
Mm.
Eight letters for the word beginning with D and nine letters for the word beginning with S.
Yes.
I want to something my award to those who've something over the years. Ah. Well, yes, Preeti is quick off the mark with a suggestion. Yes.
There might actually be a word missing there. I feel as if there should be a word missing, a word added to that to make it right. So that might be my mistake, for which I apologise. But you can say, you can use the sentence like that, but I'm sure someone will disagree. I want to something my award to those who've something over the years.
Yes. There's a...
Very some people. You're very fast, by the way.
They're getting very good at this, aren't they, Mr.
Preeti.
Duncan?
Preeti. You are... Your finger today, Preeti, is very fast. A very fast finger. And also your brain is working very well. Yes. Probably better than ours, to be honest. That's why we have two people, you see, on the live stream. We have Steve and myself, because our brains together, you see, like this, it equals one brain. So I have half a brain and Steve has half a brain. And then together, you see, we complete one brain.
Yes, people are getting one word or the other word, but one person has got them both right, who has passed form in being very quick.
Who's that?
Well, I'm not going to say yet because...
Oh, okay.
I give it away.
But Steve?
I think the answer's now out there.
Okay.
I think that is probably correct, but well, I think we know who's got that right. So Preeti was right with one of the words, but one person has got both words correct.
Mm.
And it's somebody who every week tends to be very good at this game.
Good. So here comes the answer, Mr. Cockerell. Please, can you signal the arrival of the answer? Thank you, Mr. Cockerell. Very nice.
Well done, Tomek.
Oh, I see, Tomek.
Preeti got one of the words right, was first. But then Tomek came. Because often if you get one word right, it helps you with the next one.
Yeah, it does. Because then you can see how the sentence is being formulated. Okay, then, let's have a look at the answer, shall we? The answer to this is... Bing! Ah. I want to dedicate my award to those who've supported over the years. Or, I suppose you could also say, supported me over the years. Who've supported. So, they have been giving their support. They give support. They have supported over the years. They have given you help. Maybe they've made donations, or maybe they've donated their time to help you do the thing you are doing.
Vitas is going. Bye-bye, Vitas.
Vitas, see you later, Vitas. Have a good weekend. We are having a long weekend here because it's public holiday. It is a public holiday on Monday, so we have a long weekend ahead. Not that we're doing much. I think tomorrow we're just staying at home, you see, because the weather tomorrow isn't going to be very good. Not tomorrow, not very good. Here's another one, another sentence game. Right now. Oh yes. We are using D and S. She something on her children too much. They are very something. She's something on her children too much. They are very something. She's something on her children.
Five letters beginning with S.
Yep. And six letters beginning with D. Sorry,
oh,
no.
Other way round.
Five letters beginning with D and six letters beginning with S. This is going well. There you go.
Who will be first? Lewis is going as well. Oh, no. No, I don't think so.
What?
Pam Gonis is going, according to Lewis. Vitas says that Lewis is going, but I don't think he is.
Okay.
There we go.
She's something on her children too much. They are very something. What are they? They are very something.
Well, we've got answers coming through very quickly.
Well, that doesn't seem very quick to me. Your pause.
Don't think any are quite right yet.
She something on her children too much. They are very something.
Yes, I think the word is very close to what you want to say, but not quite.
Yes. The first word is the hardest, I think. I think the first...
Is it an unusual word, Mr. Duncan?
Well, it's not unusual in English. It might be unusual to other people who are learning English as a second language, but it is a word that we use. It's not an unusual word. But for some people, it might be one that you've never heard before. I think I explained that well. I'm not sure.
Yes, we're getting this one's proving a bit more difficult, Mr. Duncan.
It's a hard one.
Spoiled, unfortunately. It's got seven letters, not six.
Yes. Don't forget, this is British English as well, you see. British English, yes. That is a clue, by the way. She's something on her children too much. They are very something.
Yes, a lot of people are getting the word, the first word, getting very close to it, but haven't quite got the spelling right.
My feet are freezing.
Yes.
My feet are actually turning to blocks of ice. I've just realised. My feet are freezing cold. Why? It's August. It's supposed to be late summer. And it's freezing cold. I can't believe how cold it is. She's something on her children too much. They are very,
yes,
very something. But what are they?
I think Alessandra has got the second word right. But so far we haven't got the first word right. Yes, nobody's got the first word yet. They've got close, and I think I know what they want to say, but nobody's got the first word right yet. First word, we're looking for five letters beginning with D.
Yes.
Assuming that Alessandra has got the second word right, then that should help you with the first one.
We're taking a break in a moment, by the way, because I need to stretch my legs, and also I need I think I need to put maybe another couple of layers of clothing on. It's so cold, isn't it?
Also close. Your first word, Maura.
How cold it is.
Isn't quite right. It's nearly there. You know what you want to say. And a lot of people have got very close to it. The second word is definitely right.
Okay, the answer is coming up before my fingers fall off and my feet turn to blocks of ice. I can't believe how cold it is. I'm standing here on an August day and it feels like February. It's very strange. Here comes the answer then, for goodness sake, Mr. Duncan. Thank you, Mr. Cockerel. The answer is... I thought this was a little difficult. Yes, maybe a little hard, perhaps. The answers are... Bing! We did actually have correct answers. We had a couple of correct answers. I did see... Yes, Maura... congratulations, Maura Mattaccini. I love your name, by the way, again.
Yeah, but that's not quite right, the second word.
Oh, I see what you mean, yes. I've got you now, yes.
First word right, dotes.
Yes. Now, the reason why I mentioned British English is because spoilt is the form of spoiled that we will use in British English. She dotes on her children too much. They are very spoilt. Dote If you dote on someone, it means you give them whatever they want, no matter how badly behaved they are, or whatever they do or say, you still treat them favourably.
You sort of worship them almost, don't you?
Yes,
yes. You spend a lot of attention on them.
So quite often, children, if your children are always wanting things or asking for things, however they sometimes maybe they don't deserve them, you will still give them what they want. You dote on them. You give them everything they want. You almost worship them. Yes, I think that's a good word to use, actually. Worship.
So well done, Maura, for getting both of them right.
She dotes on her children too much. They are very spoilt. A spoilt child is a child who always expects everything. Whatever they want, they expect to get it. They are spoilt. And I know in our time, Steve, we've come across many spoilt children.
There must be a word there must be equivalent words in other languages for this. Parents who spend a lot of attention on their children, more than would be considered normal or average.
Yes, in China they say little emperor. So a little emperor, because of course the male of the family is often preferred in China. So they will spoil, they will give everything to the son. And quite often they will become little emperors.
Mika's going. Bye, Mika. See you in October too.
Yes, in October we have our live lessons continuing, but during September we are doing something different, only September. So my live streams will continue in October, but during September we have some recorded lessons. I'm making some new content, everyone. Isn't that exciting?
Tatiana says that I dote on you too much and that you're very spoilt, Mr. Duncan.
I can safely say that I am not spoilt. Definitely not.
So are you going to take a short break?
We're
going to
have a short break, a little break. A
couple of minutes?
Well, it'll be slightly longer than that because I need to warm my hands up and I need to exercise my legs for a few moments. So we will be right back. Don't go away. We have the sentence game continuing, but right now it's time to take a little break with one of my full English lessons. This is Full English 27 with some excerpts from that very lesson. And then we will be back with more sentence games.
Oh, there you are. I've been waiting here for ages. Where have you been? Welcome to another full English lesson with me, Mr. Duncan, coming to you from the birthplace of Johnny Rotten, Phil Collins, Billy Idol, Ringo Starr, and of course, the English language. I love English so much. I might actually marry it one day. Mr. and Mrs. English, we will be the most elegant guests at the ball. I can see it all now. What a wonderful feeling. Oh, sorry. I drifted away there. I went into a daydream. I became lost in my thoughts. Okay, without any more fantasizing or daydreaming, let's get on with today's full English lesson right now. Here's an interesting word that relates to a common form of human behaviour. The word is passive aggressive. A passive-aggressive person is someone who uses non-direct resistance as a form of protest or as a means of reacting to something. A common form of this behaviour is the action of pretending to misunderstand or feign confusion. You avoid confrontation by acting dumb. Non-direct confrontation can take the form of silence. Avoiding contact or refusing to speak to someone can be described as passive-aggressive behaviour. It is common for those in long-term relationships to develop patterns of passive-aggressive behaviour. The word passive is often used to show a submissive state, whereas aggression is often seen as being the opposite. Some see this word as an oxymoron. Two words that are used together but have opposite meanings is an oxymoron. Passive-aggressive behaviour is generally seen as a normal part of human interaction. However, it can sometimes be linked to certain personality disorders. To avoid responsibility or conflict in a non-compliant way can be described as passive-aggressive behaviour. It's now time to take a look at another buzzword. A buzzword is a word or phrase that is used often during a certain period of time. Today's buzzword is tariff. The word tariff can be used as a noun or verb. As a noun, the word tariff is a form of taxation or charge which is added to the sale of goods imported from overseas. If China wants to sell their goods to the USA, then they will have to pay tariffs on what they export. The amount of each tariff depends on what types of goods are being sold. High-end or expensive items tend to have a very high tariff attached to them. Luxury items such as cars and valuable commodities sold overseas, such as oil and steel, often carry heavy tariffs. The charge is added as a way of collecting the lost revenue, which would otherwise be generated domestically. As a verb, tariff is the action of putting the charge in place. A tariff can also be described as a levy, tax, toll, duty, excise. It is a form of export tax. The country exporting the goods pays a tariff to the country that is importing them. To charge a tariff is to impose a fee. The tariffs are put in place. They are required. They have been enforced. Do you like my garden? I must say it looks rather nice today, with all the plants coming into bloom. Did you know that the word plant can be used in many ways? As a verb, the word plant means to put something in the ground. You place something in a hole and cover it with soil. You bury something in the ground. You plant something. To push something sharp into the ground is plant. You can plant a flagpole. To carefully place a small flower or tree with its roots under the soil is to plant. You plant a flower. You plant a tree. You can plant a kiss on another person. To place something where it can easily be found is to plant. The evidence was planted in his apartment by the police. As a noun, the word plant can refer to a large factory. A person who goes undercover to pose as another person is a plant. A certain species of flower or other green foliage can be described as a plant. You can plant a plant, grow a plant, nourish a plant, or like now, you can enjoy a plant.
I'll be back. I can't believe it.
You're eating, Mr. Duncan.
I am eating. I am stuffing food into my big mouth.
Oh. What have you got there, Mr. Duncan? Healthy snack.
Very healthy. I have some Wensleydale cheese with cranberries and a hot toasted crumpet. There you go. And on the top I put some mayonnaise because I was in a hurry.
Somebody says here, they must have been watching your video. Gabriella says, a kiss can be plant. Is it to plant a kiss?
You kiss someone.
If you plant, I'll let you eat, I'll explain it, shall I? If you plant a kiss on somebody, it just means place, really. It's another word for place. It's nothing to do with plants in the garden. It's just an expression that means to place a kiss on somebody, to plant a kiss. It's just a phrase you use sometimes in a sort of a humorous way, I would say. You've got all over your lips, Mr. Duncan. It looks disgusting. Have you got a tissue? There's no way to treat your viewers. They won't be seeing you for 2 weeks, and that's their a month, and that's your last memory they will see. See, Mr. Duncan, it's so disorganized. He has plenty of time in the morning, and yet he always runs out of time before a live stream and doesn't have time to eat anything.
I'm starving.
I'm not eating, Tatiana, because I had breakfast. Porridge oats with blueberries and some nuts, handful of nuts. And then for lunch, I had some scrambled eggs on toast. Mr. Duncan had nothing.
It's been a long time since I've had a handful of nuts.
So, I won't be eating anything until this evening, apart from, of course, our tea cake when this lesson finishes. There's a strange rattling noise, Mr. Duncan. I'm not sure what that is.
That's your voice.
Enjoy your crumpet, says Jamila. It looks delicious. Delish. Of course, you can shorten delicious to delish.
That's better.
If you wish to.
Oh.
You're like a child, says Tatiana. It's very harmful for you to eat food in such a way. Yes, it is. You've got to sit down, relax, chew your food properly. And anyway, there's nothing very healthy with it in a crumpet.
I have no time, you see. I have no time to relax on a Sunday. However, I will be able to relax next Sunday because I won't be doing a live stream. I'm taking September off. So no English Addict during September. Good news, there will be some new lessons. I will be very busy filming, editing, and producing some new lessons. And as I mentioned earlier as well, something I want to mention again is I will be posting my autumn lesson. My autumn lesson that I made 10 years ago. Can you believe it? I have re-edited it. I've remastered it. It looks absolutely lovely, very cinematic. So that is what I'm doing on the first of September. You can see my remastered autumn lesson, because of course autumn is about to arrive here in England as well.
I think it's come early this year, Mr. Duncan.
It feels like, I don't know about autumn, it feels like winter.
Bon appetit, says Fedor.
That feels much better.
Sergio's talking about smoking marijuana.
Marijuana?
He said you can smoke a plant. Yes. Plant a kiss, you can smoke a plant, which of course you can. We could grow them in our garden, couldn't we, Mr. Duncan? Maybe we should do that for profit. No,
what?
Maybe not. Anyway, well, is it the sentence game? Because
probably,
we've only got 2 minutes.
It is. Well, we've got a little bit longer than that, to be honest.
I wasn't, not me. I'll be off.
I wasn't going to have a break and then only come back for 2 minutes. I don't know what the sense is in that. Here we go, then. The sentence game is back again. Yes, we'll have a couple of more rounds and then we will leave you and we will be gone for 4 weeks. Can you believe it? Oh, the sentence game. Yes, let's play it again, shall we? The sentence game is here right now. Let me just put it back on the screen. And there it is. We are playing the sentence game using the letters D and S. Duncan and Steve, you see. My crumpet was delicious and satisfying, you see. Delicious, satisfying.
And savoury. Savoury.
Yes.
Something is savoury, it's the opposite of sweet.
Mm.
So there was no sugar on that, Mr. Duncan.
No sugar.
How is that possible? Because you have sugar with everything.
That was a very rare moment of time where I'm not eating anything with sugar. Although the cheese had cranberries.
Well, that's natural sugar. So
that's natural sugar. Okay, then. Here we go, sentence game. We are playing once again. Let me just make sure I've got the right one.
Yes, we don't want the one that was on before.
We do not. That would be very silly.
There's a wasp in here. It's been attracted by your crumpet, Mr. Duncan.
Yes.
Crumpet, of course, is also a word that means to have sexual relations.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't.
Yes, it does.
It doesn't.
It does.
No, crumpet is an attractive girl or a girl that looks attractive.
No, not necessarily.
You don't have crumpet.
I'm going home for some crumpet. Yes,
oh, okay.
It means I'm going to have...
relationships.
Yes.
Coitus.
Crumpet. I presume it's pleasurable, like eating a crumpet. But yes, in British English, you can use the word crumpet to mean having a bit of hanky-panky.
Is that the same as having a muffin?
Probably not.
No. Okay, then.
But... yes. So when you go to bed tonight with your partner, you can say, "Are we having some crumpet?"
If
you say that, then you may get a surprise.
Or you might say, "Are we having a little bit of muffin?"
And your partner might turn to you and say, "Not tonight, I've got a headache."
Okay. Here we go then, Steve. The sentence game. It will take several something to put up the something.
It will take several something, four letters beginning with D, to put up the...
something.
Beginning, 11 letters.
Beginning with S.
Beginning with S. Well, there's an intriguing one, Mr. Duncan. I don't think my brain is working fast enough today.
Or ever. You walked straight into that one.
It would take several something to put up the something.
Hmm.
D and S.
Yes. And the clue is think about our house. Ah.
Just our house or any house?
No, well, our house. Think about our house. Our house. Something, you see. There's a clue. It will take several something to put up the something. I think Steve knows what it is, but you can't take part, you see. You're not allowed. It will take several something to put up the something. Let's see.
So you're having some work done to your... Imagine you're having some work done to your house.
Yes, you don't need to give any more clues. We've got correct answers already.
But it doesn't take several days to put up that.
I don't know. It's just a sentence. This is not based on any fact or
it
story.
It should be based on fact.
Yes, well, it depends how big your thing is. If you've got a big one, it might take a lot longer to do it, you see. If your thing is very big, it might take a long time to do it. What? Are these new glasses you are wearing, Mr. Duncan? No, they're not. They're my old reading glasses. But you might notice there is some red at the side. I'm not going to explain why, But there is a reason why these are red at the side, and that is, oh, I'm not going to explain.
It's to do with a green screen.
It is to do with my green screen. So when I'm recording with my green screen, the reflection doesn't come onto my glasses, you see.
So are you saying that that red has been on there since Wednesday?
It has.
And you haven't taken it off?
No.
Because, of course, on Wednesday you were indoors in front of your green screen.
That's it. And, of course, this is actually for my recorded lessons that I'm making. So there is something else going on, you see. So that's what's happening during September. I'm actually putting on new lessons. And we will be covering one particular subject that I've never covered before. Wow. I'm intrigued. Even I'm intrigued. I want to find out what it is. And I'm the one making the lessons.
Tomek's done it again.
Tomek, you are a smarty pants.
Top of the class for you. I want to know how you're doing it so quickly. Is it your quick brain? You should be teaching English yourself.
How? I think one day I will find out that everyone's been using some sort of app. That's it. That just gives you the answer. Just gives you the answer to the question.
There's probably an app. Well, no, let's assume that is not the case.
No.
And
we'll have no cheating here. Here we go then. My cock is about to say hello. I will miss the cock. I really will. Do you miss the cock?
Not at all. Well done, Tomek. Although Lewis, several people got the first word right. Preeti was the first to get the first word right, and Beatrice got it as well. So did Maria.
Good.
And Lewis.
Good.
But Tomek got the second word, and therefore gets the prize. Are you going to put the answer up, Mr. Duncan?
It will. I will. And now it is coming up on the screen right now. Bing!
There we go.
It will take several days to put up the scaffolding. Ah, you see the clue there, the house, because we have had a lot of building work taking place because the house has been falling down over the past few...
Essential maintenance is the phrase you would use.
Parts of the house have been collapsing, falling off, or just dissolving in the rain.
Essential maintenance.
It will take several days to put up the scaffolding. So the support for the workmen to climb up and down. So there was the sentence game, and I hope you got it right. We did get some correct answers, didn't we?
We did. Tomek was correct with all of them, both words rather. But the first word, which must have helped him with the second one.
Mm.
Well done anyway.
Good.
Several people did get it. Strictly speaking, the first person to get it, the first word right, to get one of the words, was Preeti.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Preeti.
Beatrice and Maria.
Congratulations.
And Lewis as well.
So we are going to have one more, and I'm going to sneeze because of the barbecue, you see. There's lots of smoke.
You see, when I sneeze, when you sneeze, you expect somebody in the room to go, bless you.
It's all a smoke. Someone's having a barbecue in the smoke.
Bless you, Mr. Duncan.
The smoke has gone up my nose.
You never say that to me when I sneeze.
Very strange. Don't worry, it's nothing else. For those who are wondering, I'm sneezing because the smoke from the barbecue is going up my nose. And the really bad news is it isn't our barbecue. It's someone else's barbecue.
We couldn't be lighting barbecues and putting on a live stream at the same time.
That would be both difficult to do and also very dangerous as well. So the answer, what are we doing? Oh, yes.
We're going on to the next sentence game, last one.
The last one before we disappear. I think we'll do this one. This one. I like this one. Here we go. Oh.
Ah, yes. Right. Yes. Okay.
You have something me before with your get rich quick something. So we are looking for words beginning with... That's it.
You don't have to do that, Mr. Duncan. A little higher. You can see it.
You have something me before with your get rich quick.
Eight words beginning with D. Seven words beginning with S.
Steve has suddenly livened up.
It's the thought of going inside and getting a cup of tea and a tea cake.
Oh, yes, we're having even more food. I like it. I like it a lot. So here we go. You have something me before with your get rich quick something.
I nearly said the second word.
Sorry, Steve, you are not allowed to take part.
I can take part up here.
You are forbidden.
Here, I can take part.
You are forbidden from joining in.
Yes.
Jamelia likes my glasses with the touch of red. Oh, interesting.
Oh. It's just tape.
It's just, actually, all this is insulating tape. So this is actually insulation tape that I've stuck on the side of my glasses just to make them appear red so they don't clash with my green screen when I'm in the studio. I'm so busy at the moment. I'm doing all sorts of things. This is just part of my busy schedule, and things are going to get even more busy during September because I'm making lots of new lessons.
No answers so far.
See, Mohsen gave me a bless you. Thank you, Mohsen, for your bless you after my sneeze.
So did Corrie, so did Maria.
Yes, you didn't.
And Beatrice. I did, actually. I did.
I didn't hear it.
Yes.
I didn't hear your bless you.
Nope, that's eight words, I'm afraid. Well...
the answer coming up in a moment, and then we are going
no for correct answers yet.
Really? Oh, you have something me before with your get rich quick something. Oh, interesting. Yes, I thought this one would go, actually. I thought quite a lot of people would get this. Mustafa says you have COVID. No, I don't. Trust me, I don't. He might, but I haven't. I've got my gloves.
Strategy, unfortunately, is eight letters.
This is how cold it is, by the way, in August. It's supposed to be warm, but I've even got my gloves. This is how cold I'm feeling. I've even got my gloves, Steve. Look.
Well, Maura, there's a very good suggestion. There's a very good suggestion.
Oh, okay. That's interesting.
Yes.
Maura. Well, that's an interesting suggestion. I like that one. That's a good one.
Yes. Well, Tatiana, you've got one of them right. Well, no, I think that is right. Yes. I don't have a clue, says Corrie. Well, yeah.
Gone very quiet.
Yes, I think Tatiana's put them both together. Yes, harder than you think.
It is
harder than you think, but we have got some correct answers. In fact, we do have. But whether that's the word that you're thinking of, Mr. Duncan,
yes,
there could be another suggestion.
Yes.
So anything else for the first word?
Yes, we have some very good answers coming through.
Yes.
Some very good answers. Mr. Cockerel is waiting to cock and doodle do for the final time until October. And then we're going as well until October.
Oh, yes. Okay. A lot of people think that that is the first word. Well, it certainly fits. Are we ready, Mr. Duncan?
Mr. Cockerel. He's pecking at Mr. Steve's leg. And then he's looking around, thinking, where shall I peck next? What shall I peck? Shall I peck Mr. Steve somewhere else?
Time's up.
Time is up.
Time's up.
In many ways.
Well, Maura was first with a very good suggestion for the first word.
Okay.
So what are the answers, Mr. Duncan?
Okay, yes. This is the final sentence game of August and also the final sentence game until October. Can you believe it? I can't believe it, Steve. I can't believe it. Here we go. The answers to the sentence game are... Bing! Ah,
there we go. Yes, well, that was correct.
You have deceived me before with your get rich quick schemes.
Well done, Maura.
Yes, well done, Tatiana as well.
And Tatiana got the last word, and then Tatiana put them both together and got deceived and schemes.
Yes, good.
So well done, Tatiana.
You have deceived me before with your get rich quick schemes. So when we say get rich quick, we mean something that you can do or something that a person tells you about that promises to make you rich very quickly. However, as we all know in life, if something seems too good to be true, quite often it is too good to be true, which means that it's not true, it's not real. So a person might promise you, they might say, you can get rich very quickly if you follow my plan, but quite often they are not profitable.
Palmyra, between you and me, it's a possibility. It may happen.
Really? Oh, okay then. I don't know what that is. What might be happening?
Just between me, Palmyra, and everybody else, you are excluded, Mr. Duncan.
Okay, that's nice.
I'll tell you afterwards. You never know.
You never know.
You never know.
Whatever,
is what I'm saying.
Whatever it is Steve is talking about, you never know.
Well, Mr. Duncan, it's time to go.
That's it. I can't believe it. These are my last live words until October. Even though I think Mr. Steve thinks, don't cry.
There's a tear in my eye. I'm going to miss the spontaneity of the live stream.
I am also getting moisture, but not in my eyes, somewhere else.
It's in your mouth because you're hungry. You want to get your mouth around another muffin, don't you, Mr. Duncan?
I want to get a big crumpet in my mouth, or maybe a tea cake.
Tea cake coming up. Well, everybody, best of luck with your English over the next month, and I look forward to seeing you all again with Mr. Duncan live again in October. So bye-bye for now.
Thank you, Steve.
You're not going to fade me out, no?
Shall I fade you out? Okay then, if I can find something to fade you out with.
It would look professional.
Yes, it would look very professional.
So I'll say again, I look forward to seeing you all again in October.
Thank you, Steve. And Steve is now going to make a cup of tea and also a tea cake. It's so cold. I can't begin to tell you how cold it is today. It doesn't seem like August. I must be honest with you, it does not feel like August at all. Thanks for your company today. Yes, it is time to say goodbye for the month of August. And also in September, we won't be here live. English Addict will return in October. But don't worry, I'm not going anywhere. I'm still here. There will be some new lessons coming in September, including on Tuesday, we have the updated remastered version of my autumn lesson. So the autumn lesson will be available from Tuesday, the 1st of September. I have gone to a lot of work, a lot of trouble and effort to update, to re-edit and also remaster the autumn lesson, so that will be coming your way on Tuesday, don't forget. It will be available on Tuesday, the 1st of September. And that, as they say, is almost that. I hope you've enjoyed today's live stream. We've had Mr. Steve. We've had, of course, you as well. The most important part of all of this is you, because without you, we wouldn't have a live stream, to be honest with you. See you very soon. I hope you have a good rest of the weekend. I hope you have a good rest of August. Enjoy tomorrow. And of course, I hope you have a super duper September as well. New lessons in September. And also we have the updated version of my autumn lesson as well. This is Mr. Duncan saying thanks for watching. Very nice to see you all here today. But don't worry, I'm not going away. I'm not departing. I'm not going anywhere. There will be recorded lessons, some new material. Can you believe it? There will actually be new lessons coming your way during September. Until we meet again, this is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English saying thanks for your company, thanks for watching, see you live in October. Enjoy the month of September and my recorded lessons as well. And of course, until the next time we meet here on YouTube, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. Ta-ta for now.